only being who's doomed. No tongue would ask, no eye would mourn. I never caused a thought of gloom, a smile of joy since I was born. In secret pleasures, secret tears, this changeful life has slipped away. As friendless after 18 years, as lone as on my natal day. There have been times I cannot hide. There have been times when this was drear, when my sad soul forgot its pride and longed for one to love me here. But those were in the early glow of feelings since subdued by care, and they have died so long ago, I hardly now believe they were. First melted off the hope of youth, then fancy's rainbow fast withdrew, and then experience told me truth in mortal bosoms never grew. It was grief enough to think mankind all hollow, servile, insincere. But worse, to trust to my own mind and find the same corruption there.
Friends, I love.
November the 24th, 1834. Anne and I have been peeling apples for Charlotte to make a pudding. Aunt has come into the kitchen just now and said, "Where are your feet, Anne?" Anne answered, "On the floor, Aunt." The gondols are discovering the interior of Galvin. Sally Mosley watching in the back kitchen. It is past 12 o'clock, and we want to go out to play. The kitchen is very untidy. Anne and I have not done our music lesson, which consists of B major. I wonder where we shall all be if all goes well in the year 1874, in which year I shall be in my 57th year. Hoping we shall all be well at that time. June 26, 1837. A bit past 4 o'clock. Charlotte working in Aunt's room. Aunt working in the little room. Papa gone out. Tabby in the kitchen. The emperors and empresses of Gondal and Galdine preparing to depart for the coronation, which will be the 12th of July. Ascended the throne this month. Zamorna at Evesham, all tight and right, in which condition it is hoped we shall all be this day 4 years. Let us hope for the best. Aunt, come, Emily, it's past 4 o'clock. Emily, yes, Aunt. Exit, Aunt. July the 30th, 1841. It is Friday evening, near 9 o'clock. Wild, rainy weather. We are all stout and hearty. I guess that at the time appointed for the opening of this letter, we shall be all merrily seated in our own sitting room. Debts will be paid off. And we shall have cash in hand to a considerable amount. It will be a fine summer evening, and Anne and I will perchance slip out into the garden to peruse our papers. The gondoliers are at present in a threatening state, but there is no open rupture as yet. All the princes and princesses of the royalty are at the Palace of Instruction. I have a good many books on hand, but I'm sorry to say that, as usual, I make small progress with any. than ever I was in the whole course of my incarnate existence. The above precious lines are the fruits of 1 hour's most agonizing labor between 6:30 and 7:30 in the evening. I have dreamt in my life dreams that have stayed with me ever after and changed my ideas. They have passed through and through me like wine through water and changed the color of my mind. I dreamt once I was in heaven. Heaven did not seem to be my home. And I broke my heart, weeping to come back to earth. And the angels were so angry that they flung me out into the middle of the heath on the top of Wuthering Heights, where I awoke sobbing for joy. My birthday. I am 27 years old today. Anne and I went on our first long journey by ourselves. During our excursion, we were Ronald McGalkin, Henry Angora, Juliet Agustina, Rosabella Esmolden, Ellen and Julian Egremont, Catherine Navarre and Cordelia FitzAthnold, escaping from the palaces of instruction to join the royalists who are hard driven by the victorious republicans. As bright as ever. We intend sticking by the rascals as long as they delight us, which I am glad to say they do at present. We are all in decent health. Tiger died last year. Keeper and Flossie are well. Also the canary acquired 4 years since. Thank you. Messenger of hope comes every night to me and offers for short life eternal liberty.
He comes with western winds, with evening's wandering.
Thank you.
struggles of distress and fierce impatience end.
Unuttered harmony.
Trust thy might. Trust thou my constancy. the thing that irks me most is this shattered prison, after all. I'm tired. Tired of being enclosed here. I'm weary to escape into that glorious world, to be always there, not seeing it dimly through tears, and yearning for it through the walls of an aching heart, but really with it and in it. I cannot live without my life. I cannot live without my soul.